animations and find one of them for part two. But for part one, the focus is on animation that actually adds to the presentation of the site. In other words, why is the site's content better because it has this animation? Let me show you an example. I doubt it. This is actually that's not the one I want. The one I wanted was from actually from a veterinary school. Web was so much better before these darn kids got on it. Started doing crazy stuff. Well, we'll look at this. There we go. Okay. That's not particularly good. All right. The point is, though, the one that I wanted to have was from a veterinary school, and what it did is it showed the horse's skeletons and musculature as it was running. And the idea there is you can't see what a horse's bones are doing when they're running if you look at a video of a real horse, right? Because the bones are inside the horse. The horse gets in the way. You can't see the bones. Therefore, an animation is something that actually allows you to see something that you couldn't see with a video. Things that are unrealistic to see from a video. So that would be an example of, in this particular veterinarian school, the lesson that they were trying to teach, they were discussing the way the horses moved and all that. That would be a case of finding something, finding an animation that actually like was there for a reason. It actually was the best way to show the content available. And that's sort of what I want you to do to find the assignment. I also then want you to find a bad case of animation. People put animations up there that they think are going to be good and effective, but really just make things difficult or are distracting or get in the way or are gratuitous. This is actually bugging me. Let me go to last spring and find it.
takes a bunch of pictures.
Okay.
And it kind of makes it into an animation. It's
sure.
Kind of actually cool to watch.
We'll do that in a second. Actually, this example, no wonder I couldn't find it. This example does not appear to be coming up. What do I want to search for on YouTube?
I think the title of it's called Stop Motion Whiteboard Video.
Stop Motion Whiteboard Video. Which one?
Good question. I don't know.
Okay.
It looks like that Snowy G17 one 5 years ago.
This one?
I think so. Could be. I don't know. It was just cool to watch. I don't know if it exactly applies to what you're talking about.
Okay.
You got that type and I didn't.
That's okay. It's the Doobie Brothers.
It's like the guy took... You can tell he took... Doing this.
Right. Example of something that's cool, but I wouldn't say that like getting a message across, you know, doing that. So what I want you to do is I actually want you to do both. So you'll find a total of three animations. A good one that helps communicate something or makes the page more effective. Alright. A one that you think really adds nothing to the page or doesn't really do anything, if anything is distracting and gets in the way, you know, a dancing cat loading on a page that, you know, is going on. And then lastly, just find something that's cool, just something that's fun that you think is a good example. Now, when we think of animation, animation on the web means maybe a little bit different than animation in other contexts. Because a slideshow could be considered an animation, right, where you have slides fading in and fading out. You know, the word animation means bring to life, right? Most web pages, if you look at them, are dead. They just sit there looking at you, all right? So even something like a slideshow that plays, you know, if we go to LC's website, we'll see a slideshow that plays on the front page. There we go. I would call that an animation as well, all right? It's not an animation in the way that you think of, like, a cartoony sort of thing. But it is bringing some sort of life to the page. Now, animations can either be sort of on their own, or they can be interactive. Like this one is interactive, because I can go and I can scroll back to a page that I want. So some animations are interactive. Sometimes people just have interactive menus or interactive links, and that's a form of animation. So when we talk about animation, I want you to sort of broaden your scope and not just think of, you know, cartoony kind of things, but any kind of stuff where the page sort of comes to life, stuff that moves on the page, whether it be based on something that the user does or something, you know, not based on what the user does. All right? So find something that's effective. This, we could critique this to say if this is good or bad or indifferent, but at least this is an attempt to use an animation to get some message across, right? To help communicate some stuff about the college. So this would qualify either for part one or for part two, depending on what your view of it is. Do you think this is effective or not? All right? For part three, where you find a fun animation, then the animation that was pointed out before probably would be the kind of thing that I'm looking for. All right? I would like you to take the time to think about what benefits there are to animation compared to the other multimedia elements. Why is it good? What does it provide that other multimedia elements don't provide? And there's that bulletin board, and we'll spend some time discussing that on Wednesday. So we'll probably spend a few minutes talking about that Wednesday, maybe a few other thoughts on animation, and then get into animation via HTML5. In the past, for the most part, animation on the web meant Flash. With HTML5, that sort of notion is expanding to a more standard way of presentation. And really, all the reasons that we gave when we talked about HTML5 incorporating video on it applies when we talk about Flash as well. There's no need for a plugin, less issues, and so on.
And can, if you have the right video editor, can you use video editor to create animations that are MP4 or OGG?
Well, you can make some kind of animations with that, not others. In other words, the kind of animation that you would make, that I would really categorize more like a video. I mean, for the purpose of this class. So like if you were to create a video and you were going to animate it, I would describe that more as like a video than an animation.
Simply, this is something that I need to animate because I can't do it with a camera. I can't do it with a still camera. I can't do it with a video camera. I can make a graphic drawing of it, and I can make the things that I want to move, move.
I'm not following your question. Could you just repeat your question?
Well, I don't know how I would present such a long animation.
Okay, well,
I don't know how I would create it other than I don't know how to make this thing. It's too long to be a GIF.
Right.
Which I would construct frame by frame.
Right.
I'm going to construct something frame by frame.
Well,
it may wind up being a lot of frames, and it might be so many, it has to be a video.
Okay. Well, we'll talk about specifically how to do. The animation that you're going to do in this class is not going to be, like, extensive. All right? You may do something like create a slideshow like this. All right? Whereas you will take and through your HTML5 code, rotate among through a series of pictures. So that might be an animation that you might make. Or you might make a little animated drawing of like some sort of logo that comes in. So yeah, I mean, don't let the term animation intimidate you. You know, this class is just to get a sort of a sense of how this is going to work in HTML5 and put together something rudimentary. So yeah, this should
be. That may make it difficult to accomplish what I wanted to accomplish with the page.
Okay.
But
well, we can talk about
that's
it.
That's okay.